Good morning, everybody. So sorry, I'm a couple minutes late. We got caught up junking this morning. So, you know, I was like, oh my gosh, I gotta get back to do my video. I'm gonna give it a minute here for everybody to join us. I know, here, you want your bun. Say hi to everybody first. Here, Lucky, say hi. Hi, lady. She's too excited about her treat today. Here you go. You good? Okay, take it and run. Take it and run. Alright guys, so I'm going to get a couple things here set up and then we will start. I'm going to actually adjust this a little bit. I'm loving my new phone stand. It is so cool. Alright, there. Get it down here maybe. Alright. I might sit to do this. No, I can't sit to do this because this is a standing project. I'm so excited to show you guys today. Oh, I'm so excited. Hi guys. Good morning. Awesome. Okay, give me 1 second here. Okay. All right. Okay, so I wanted to, let me move this real quick. My lighting is like all messed up today. All right, let's see. Okay, so originally I wanted to do this whole entire project from the very beginning. However, of course, I'm in Johnstown, PA, and it is so ugly out today. So I couldn't really take my phone out and spray paint and start from the very beginning. So I kind of started this project already this morning. Sorry. All right, let's see here. Good morning. Hi guys. Lainey says hi too. She took her treat and ran. So she's not feeling too, like, I guess, social today. I don't know. Let's see. Hi Becky. Hi guys. Alright, so as you guys know, we were doing the old bike rims, and hang on 1 second. I have another one around here somewhere. So I have been on a crazy bike rim, tire, whatever you want to call it, spree. Like, I don't even want anything else. All I want is these stupid bike rims. So I have about 4 of them now, all right, between my mom, my dad, Duncan, and us. I have gotten 4. So, sorry, I'm catching my breath. I ran up the steps. Okay, I'm so out of shape. It's terrible. So I already started on one, as you guys can see behind me, because I just had to. Like, I could not wait until today's video to do one of these. Hi, Lainey. I don't have anything else for you. So I'll share with you guys what I did to the last one, and then we're going to make one today, okay? All right. So this isn't completely finished because I didn't have time yesterday, but this is what I'm doing with the bike rims. Woohoo! I'm so excited to share this with you guys today. Like, this is probably my favorite project so far. I love these. I love them. They're so pretty. So these were just old, and it's nice to have the older ones. You can use just like a newer bike rim, but they don't look as nice. Okay. I don't think they do, but it's just up to you guys. So these I pulled out of somebody's trash. Actually, these two came together. They were off the same bike. So what I did was I removed, I call it the guts of the wheel. So the axle and everything else that was in between here that actually spun, held and spun on the bike, I removed. Now that did take some muscle power. I have a clamp downstairs on our table that I used a wrench with, and I took those off. So if you do find them, I would take them off because they stick out about that far, okay? So you don't want that rubbing on your door or anything. This one here, I got lucky. Somebody must have just changed the whole tire, the whole rim and everything. So this one does not have one, okay? I'll probably, when I do this one, I'll probably take this off, okay? Just so it does not scratch the back of the door, okay? It'll lay flat, but I'm not gonna do that one today. That's gonna be a bigger one. All right, so what I did was remove those, all right? And I am gonna walk you through today what and how I did this, okay? So really, I just went to the Dollar Tree, and if you have flowers sitting around, this is an easy project. So I went to the Dollar Tree, got 2 sets. Well, I got 3 of each. three of each. So $3 is pretty, well, four if you count this, the chalkboard. So $4 to make this whole project. And you'll need some twine also, okay? Or if you have a door hanger, one of these awesome things, you don't even need the twine, okay? It's up to you guys. I use the twine because I like the twine better, and then I also hang it with the door hanger. So it's up to you guys, okay? All right, so I'm gonna put this one back. Lainey, I don't have anything else for you. Lainey's looking at me like, Mom, I want more food or treat. I don't have anything. Do you want to be in the video today? Look. What? Do you want to help me today? Can I have your paw? Thank you. You're very, very sweet. All right, so I don't know. She's going to be needy, I guess, today. All right, so I'm going to bend you guys down here a little bit more. Let's see. Muscle power. Yes, babe. My husband's probably laughing at me down there because he knows I don't have arm strength. So my muscle power is like not very strong. Let's see here. Oh, I have so many comments already. Awesome. Hi, guys. Yes, Megan, she was social distancing. You're right. She's back now. She keeps nudging me every so often. So let's see. Yes, Amy, he is. He is. Awesome. All right, guys. So, as far as the bike rims, now I spray painted because there was no way I was going to sit here and paint each one of these little spokes and everything. I just didn't want to be doing that. So I took this out. I used a metal hanger, which I have somewhere. I don't know where I put it. I'm like all over the place today. Oh, here it is. So I used a metal hanger. I hung it up like this, okay? And then I just went over it with the can of spray paint, okay? And it took 2 coats, and it covered pretty well. And it's not perfectly covered because I figured I'm going to use a little bit of sandpaper anyway to remove some of that white paint just to make it look rustic, okay? So I just cleaned them off, blew them off a little bit, washed them down a tiny, tiny bit. They weren't bad. I got lucky. They weren't too filthy or anything. So I did that, and then I just spray painted. And you can spray paint them any color you want, all right? So that was going to be part of the video today. However, it's pouring down rain outside, and there's no way I could take my phone out and spray these at the same time with you guys today. So sorry I did that step without you. Hi, Lainey. You're fine. I'm trying to do video. You're okay. All right, so we're going to go ahead and move on to the next step, which is the sandpaper. And everything you need for this project, you just need some flowers, and you can, you know, use Dollar Tree flowers. That's what I'm doing for this one. You need, you're fine. You need a chalkboard, okay? Or if you don't have a chalkboard, that's okay. You can even print out something on a piece of paper, make it decorative. It's totally up to you, okay? But I'm using a chalkboard. I have a lot of chalkboards, so we're going to see today which one I want to use. I have these cute little arrows that I might use today. I don't know. We'll see. I tried to use hot glue on here. It did not stick because of the metal. So I'm just using the super glue. Okay. Same one I always do. And of course I use just regular, I'm supporting Ace today, Ace Hardware. and I use their spray paint, and this is a flat white today. Okay, let me see here. Let me read these. Hi, Addie! My little niece is watching. Hi! All right, so now I'm going to take this sandpaper, and I'm going to go ahead and just sand down all the edges here. So anything that's raised is going to go back down to the metal, okay? So I'm just real lightly sanding. Hi, I know. You're staring at me today. You gonna help me out today? Yeah. She's just sitting here like, I know you have more treats, but I don't. You're a little piggy today. You already had your treat, baby. Lainey, I don't have any more. She's digging in my pocket. I put it in my pocket earlier, so I think she thinks I have another one, and I definitely don't. You had it already. You ate it. So all I'm doing is just going around that edge, and you can see it on there actually, and just bringing out the metal underneath, okay? Just to highlight it. And you guys don't even have to paint these. If you find one and you just like the way it looks, go for it. Just keep it the same. I'm just sanding it down to make it look more rustic-y since that's my, you know, my thing. If there's no sanding or chalk paint or something in my videos, then it's not me. So, all right, and I'm going to do the same thing to the inside here a little bit. Just highlighting that metal all around. And these are pretty simple. They really are. It doesn't take much to make these. They're really fun. So hopefully this will be one of my things that I take to fairs and festivals, hopefully, and sell them at a booth. So I'm hoping, just depends on everything that's going on with this virus, if we're going to have all that kind of stuff this year. All right. So I'm just going to take that around there. Awesome. And I'm going to scuff this a little bit. So this is the back wheel. This one is, and you can tell that because it does have where the chain and stuff is to go. So it's totally up to you. Whatever side you like best, you can use. Okay. This side kind of looks pretty cool. So I might use this side. We'll see. We'll see what it looks like. So I'm going to do that to both sides there. Just going around that whole rim, removing the paint right off the edges here. And this is not chalk paint. This is just regular acrylic spray paint. It's a matte finish, okay? Because I wanted to make it look like chalk, but when I went shopping yesterday, of course, Ace Hardware, I don't think has chalk paint. So I just kind of settled for the acrylic today. Take this around. And I will read my comments here in a minute. I don't have my touchpad. I don't know what I did with it. And I was running late for this video, so I wasn't going to make you guys wait longer just so I could find my touchpad. Alright, so that's pretty good. So I'm just going to go around the flat surface of this and kind of just scuff it up just a tiny bit. Not too much. Very light pressure right now that I'm using to do this. There we go. That looks pretty good. Same thing to the other side. And like I said, I did two coats on this. It took two coats to cover it pretty decently, so you shouldn't need three. It was covered pretty well. Alright, looking good. Okay, and then I'm just going to do this part here. A little bit, real lightly scuffing this up to make everything look the same here. Awesome. This one actually has words on the center of it, so let's see if I can get those to stand out. Eh, it might not. Okay. Alright, so that looks pretty good there. My nose is itchy because of all the dust. Alright, I'm just going to wipe this down. Make sure there's no dust or anything on it. Looks pretty good. Alright, so if you look pretty closely, it's hard to see in the video, but you can kind of see how I sanded and removed some of that paint around the edges there just to make it look more rustic-y, okay? Rustic-y. Right? That's a word. Alright, let me catch up on some comments. I'm going to bring this down. Now that I have my phone thing that moves, I can bring this closer now to read comments. It's so cool. Let's see here. Michelle, thanks. Yes, yes, oh, welcome. Welcome. This is your first time here. Yes, Lainey is my little helper. She's very nosy, and whatever I'm doing, she wants to know, and as soon as I say good morning, everybody, she's at my side, because she thinks she gets a treat. She thinks that's like a thing, so she's like, oh, mom's got a treat for me. So yeah, you'll see her at least in the beginning of every one of my videos. Yes, absolutely. And if she's having a very, like, rough day where she just wants to be by me and everything, you'll see her for the whole video pretty much. She'll stick her nose in here and greet everybody. But welcome. I hope you like my video. Let's see here. Okay, someone did a live showing how to move the bearing and middle piece. Yes. And you can do that. Absolutely, Ellie. I removed all of that stuff earlier today, and you can go further and you can take this stuff off. That's completely up to you. But when I did that one behind me, I tested it on my door. It laid pretty flat. The only thing that I'll probably do to that is, do you know the little pads that go on the bottom of your chairs and stuff? The little foam pads? I might put one of those on the back piece of this right here just to keep it from scratching. This is pretty smooth though, so I think you should be okay. I was going to include removing all that in my video this morning, but however, it's like pouring down rain outside and I was trying to spray paint it outside and do all that and just was not working. So I might later go back and make another video on that and just add it to this. So we'll see, but it's pretty easy. You just move the bolt and take all that out of there, the guts out of it. Let's see here, Cynthia. Oh, awesome. You've made four of them. So cool. Awesome. Good morning, Nancy. Awesome. Hi, Michelle from Texas. Awesome. Welcome. Think if you want. Oh, thank you, Ellie. Yes. Yes, absolutely. If you would like to, that would be much appreciated. Yeah, I'm thinking it's pretty easy. I don't know. I'm pretty handy with stuff like that, and I did remove most of it, but I think I'm going to keep this part. But yeah, definitely, you can send me the link, absolutely. Let's see here. Awesome. All right, so I'm going to move you guys back here, and I'm going to point you down again, and we're going to go ahead and finish this, okay? So, now that I have that down, it's up to you guys. Let me move this a little bit so you can see. So I kept the reflector on these. You don't have to. You can remove them. And mine just got spray painted white because I didn't mask it or anything. And it was kind of like yellow tint, and I didn't want that anyway. So I'm just going to keep it on there because my chalkboard might cover it. If you look on these, so every rim has a hole in it, okay? Because that's where the air thing goes through. I don't know what all the terms are, but where you would fill your tire up with air, that's where that goes through. So right here is where I'm going to be hanging it from. So I'm going to use farmer's twine, and this is my middle spot, so it'll be hung like this, okay? So that's just kind of where I pick to hang it. That way you have a spot for your string and it goes straight through there. So this here will be the bottom of my sign or my wreath, my bike wreath, okay? So what I did first was I got my flowers, and it completely is up to you guys how you want to do this. You can put them at the bottom, you can put them at the top. I mean, it's yours. You can be creative with it. You don't even have to use flowers. If you want to use something else, that's fine. I just thought flowers would look really pretty, especially these red ones. And then the pink ones behind me, I thought looked really pretty too. The orange, pink, peach, whatever you want to call it. Let's see here. So I'm going to cut all these little labels off. And these are all from the Dollar Tree. So they were a dollar a piece. You can't beat that. And I'm sure the Dollar Tree has chalkboards too. I have chalkboards laying around everywhere. So I just grabbed some of the chalkboards I had today. And we'll see which one I want to use. Let's see here. Come on. These little stickers. These little tags on these flowers drive me crazy. Oops. All right. So I like fake flowers for this project because they're easy to move, and you definitely need something that's easy to move. Okay, so what I did was I looked here. This is my top, right? So I want it to kind of sit. Now I'm going to figure out how I kind of want this to look, where I want to put these. I could do it like I did my last one, which was I just put two flowers there and then the chalkboard down here. But let's see. Let's see if we can do something different with this one. Maybe not. I might not even like it. Okay. Oops. That over there. Still have a sticker on there. So with these, let's see here. Maybe we'll do some on both sides. And the chalkboard also helps cover up this stuff as well. Okay. So it is kind of nice to have that chalkboard. Something just fell on me. I don't know. Maybe a I don't know what that was. Anyway, let me keep going. Okay, so I was silly and only brought three of these. I don't know why I bought them in an odd number. I never do that. So I'm going to try to split this So I think I'm going to do both of these on the side because I want one longer anyway. If you guys can see this, hang on. You guys might not be able to see everything I'm doing here. There we go. Now you can see better. I'm loving this new phone thing. Okay, so I want these to extend up higher on both sides. And then I'm just going to split this one. And I'm going to place it a little bit lower just so it looks fuller. There we go. Okay, so that's kind of how I want this one laid out, I think. I think it looks really cute. I like this center of this, so I'm going to leave it on this side. And then let's see what we want to do. I'm trying to decide if I want to do it like the one behind me or if I want to use a little chalkboard sign. These are arrows. I'm not quite sure if I want the arrows. Because really, if you have like welcome to your front door, you don't want an arrow pointing to your garage or anything. So I think we're going to hold off on the arrows. Let me see here. I have this little chalkboard. That might actually be kind of cute. Let's see. I have a billion of these things sitting around. I probably even have more than what I know of right now. Let's see. I have more comments here. Awesome. Hi, Becky. Your friend to the doctor. Catch you. Okay, Becky, have fun. I will see you later. Talk to you later, I guess. All right, so let's see. I could put that there. I don't know if I like this chalkboard either. So maybe we will use this. See, I'm back and forth too, you guys. It's not just you. Let me see if I have another straight one. I thought maybe I had one, but I might have used it. So let me check. No, maybe I don't. Okay, so I don't have another straight one. I must have used it. I think I used it for, I bet I know what I used it for. I used it for the herb sign for the little wagon that I did. Okay, so we are just going to use this. And I can always replace it later. So what I did was I wanted it to hide all of the stems and stuff down here. So you want, because right now the stems are coming out of the bottom here in between this chalkboard sign and the wheel. And you don't want that because it's going to make this uneven. And there's nothing really holding these in place. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to weave these. I'm going to take this off here. Take this side. So I'm looking at this. And right now, I know that these flowers can move. You can pretty much put them somewhere and they're going to stay where you put them. But I need something holding this down. And the hot glue, you can try it. I just don't think it held up well. So what I did was I weaved these in and out. You're just going to pick a spot here and you're going to weave. And it can be kind of hard. It can be tricky. So kind of make sure you know where you want to put them because it's a pain in the butt to get them back out. Okay. I'm just going to weave these through here. And I want these taller anyway. So right in there looks pretty good. So that's in there really good. It's not going to just fall out. Okay. And you guys can glue them if you want. That's up to you. But the wheel holds them anyway. So it works out pretty well. All right. So I'm just going to move all these little leaves up on my fake flowers here. Hopefully you guys can see this. Okay. Just to get them out of the way. Because I'll be putting on the chalkboard sign here too. And then I'll adjust all these back later. Okay. So there's that. Good. And what I like about fake flowers too is you can adjust them. So, you know, if they're facing the wrong way or whatever, you can kind of just move them, which makes it really nice. So my other side, I'm going to do the same way, keeping in mind that my center, I got to keep my center there. Okay. So I'm just going to see where I put this one, make this one somewhat close to it, weave that in and out of there, just like that. And make sure that they're pretty even on both sides. Good. I'm actually tucked this one in the back here. So they do bend pretty easily, which is kind of good. Okay, there we go. All right, so I'm going to move these little leaves up here and I'm going to adjust these. And it doesn't have to be perfect on this step because you're actually going to move them anyway after your chalkboard sign's on. That's kind of when you're going to make sure they look nice and full and or where they need to be. Okay, there we go. So I'm just gonna bend those kind of up and back a little bit. Okay, so I'm just going to hold this up. That looks pretty even, looks pretty good. This one here is not kind of, trying to see here. Move this one up a little bit. This one's not holding where I want it to, so I'm just going to move this up. It's a lot of messing around, just like making a wreath, you know, same stuff. And this paint is holding up really well. It's not even coming up, like, when I'm, you know, I'm definitely being pretty rough with this. So the acrylic spray paint is holding up really, really well. All right, good. Adjusting it a little bit. These poor flowers are probably like, what the heck? Okay. So I'm going to tuck that in there. I'm going to tuck this one in there also. So my last one, I did clip off some of this because I only used it on one side and it was down further. But this one here looks like I don't need to clip off any of the stem of the flowers. They tuck right into there and they lay nice and flat. So I don't have to worry about that on here. Let's see. This one's just being stubborn. Good. I could probably run those through that one, but I don't want to get up too close to that. I'm talking to myself. Sorry. There we go. Okay, that looks better. All right, so I just have them. I know they don't look absolutely beautiful yet, but I do have them laying pretty equal on each side, keeping in mind this is going to be the top here. So you want to make sure you keep that in mind because you don't want it to hang lopsided. You don't want to be like, oh, crap, I forgot where the middle was. All right, let's see here. Cut the ends of the arrow. Yes, Ellie, I did think about cutting the ends of this. I might still. We'll see. It might work out. Because that gives me a pretty long sign still. I might actually do that. I did think of that. I was like, oh, maybe I should cut this. So we'll see. Probably will end up. Let's see. Starting my... messages anymore. Oh, that's okay. That's all right. Thank you for watching. You're so sweet. Thank you for sharing, Christine. Awesome. Oh, thank you, Kathy. Thank you so much for watching. All right, guys. So now I'm going to, I split my third one because silly me, I didn't get an even number, but I think this is going to fill it out pretty good. So I'm just going to move all my little leaves up here. And you guys can mix flowers too. It does not matter. I just got the simple, like I like the reds and pinks, so I just figured I'd just use these. So now with this one, I do have clippers, but I don't think I do anymore. So I'm just going, if you pull these, they should come loose. Yeah, watch me like not be able to do this now. I did have a pair of clippers up here earlier and I don't know what I did with it. Let's see if my scissors, there we go, my scissors cut it. Okay, so I'm using one on this side, and I want it a little bit lower now because I want it fuller. I don't want to stick it up here because then you have all this room here unless you're putting your sign up higher, but then your sign's not going to cover this, okay? So I am going to just move this down a little bit, okay, about right in there, and I will have to clip these ones. So right about where these flowers ended at the shortest point, I'm overlapping those. And same thing with this. I'm going to go through these. Actually, let me go this way. Go the same way I did with this one. Hi, babe. He is bringing up his saw. What you got going on over there? You're not cutting any. This little, he wants to cut this little thing with the huge saw. You can cut it with a huge saw. I don't care. Just don't cut your finger off, dude. I don't know. I was just going to do it with a this. What? It'll work. Thank you. He's so sweet. All right. So I'm going to tuck this under here. I got one good husband. That's for sure. All right. So that looks pretty. That looks better on that side. And same thing over here. Thank you, honey. Look at that. I have my own little assistant over here. I'm liking it. Aw, thank you. Do you want to come on camera and say hi to everybody? He's just like silent. He doesn't even want his voice on camera. All right, so that looks better. There you go. Awesome. Thank you. my video downstairs. So he came up and cut that board for me. That was sweet. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing on this side. Just where those end. About right in there. Looks pretty good. Okay. And then I'm going to, same thing. I'll run it under this one here. These flowers are fighting me, man. They're pretty strong. These Dollar Tree flowers, they hold up really well. Lainey, you scaring yourself? You definitely are scaring yourself. She just knocked over some boxes I had folded there and scared herself. Oh, this dog. There we go. All right, that looks pretty good there. Hi, I know. You're okay. What? Did Daddy scare you? Or did you scare yourself? A little bit of both, huh? Yeah. Okay. So, I'm just going to bend this through here. And you guys can cut off some of these. That's up to you. I don't know where I put my... I did have those. You guys know me and losing stuff during my videos, so God only knows where I put them. Okay. So, that looks pretty good there. And then my sign. Move all these little leaves up here. So if you like making wreaths, this is a whole new outlook on wreaths. You got your bike rims now. Oh, that's gonna pop off of there. That's gonna be pretty close, but I think we can do it. Okay, so keeping in mind, my middle's there. Pretty good. Maybe move this over a little bit. So now I'm just being picky. I wanna make sure everything's pretty well lined up. Looks pretty good. Okay, so now I'm gonna lay this down, going off the top of my where I'm going to hang it from. Okay, making sure it's centered. Looks good. Okay, and I like that he cut this sign a little bit shorter, because I think the arrows would have been too long anyway. So now I'm kind of just deciding where I want to put this. If I want it, I want it there, I don't think. Because I move these a little bit shorter. Let me move these up a little bit. Do-do-do-do-do. Come on. There we go. All right. And this one. Sorry, guys. I'm like hardcore thinking right now. There we go. Tuck that back underneath there. All right, so I just moved those a little bit more just so I have more room for this sign. And then I will fix everything around it. Okay. All right, so now that I have that, and that's going to cover all those little stems of that, I am going to go ahead and glue this on there. I like it because it hides it. Perfect. All right, making sure that's lined up. And what I was doing was I was actually standing this up, getting that top of that right there, that little hole, and making sure I knew exactly where I needed to glue this so it wasn't lopsided or anything. So this does take some movement here. All right, it looks good. So I kind of know where I want to glue it. So I'm going to get my Gorilla Glue. I'm just going to do one side at a time here just so I don't move this. Perfect. And I will, after this, I want to print out on my Cricut. You can write with chalk if you have chalk, that's fine. Or a chalk marker or anything, that works too. But I am going to actually print out a saying on my Cricut. I just did not have time to do it before I went live today, because everything I do is last minute. I'm not good at planning. I'm really not. And I'm a procrastinator, so I'm like, oh, it's like 10 o'clock and we're driving around looking at junk. I'm like, I'm good. I think I have everything ready. Definitely don't. All right. Oops. I moved that a little bit. There we go. All right, so I'm just holding this here until it dries. Dries pretty quickly. I might not have put enough on this side. Oh, they're popping up. Hang on. I need to get some Gorilla Glue, hot glue. I just have not gotten it yet. It's This is just fighting me. It didn't fight me like this yesterday. So, of course, it's on my video. It couldn't have been easy on the video. What you doing, boob? Hmm? I'm just going to do one side at a time here. Oh, my finger's sticking to it. That's great. Oops. I'm making a mess. Alright, so that side seems to be holding down pretty well. We'll try this one again. There we go. Alright. Oh, glue. Me and glue. Alright, almost done. Let me read some comments. I look weird sitting here like this, but it's okay. Hi, Lori. Alright, I think outside's hanging on. We're good there. Oh, he brought me clay. Oh, he's like sucking up to me today. What do you want? He brought me clamps. Look how sweet. I already got him Dunkin' Donuts this morning, so I don't know. Alright, so I'm going to let that sit on there for a second. And while that's drying, I'm going to go ahead and adjust these flowers a little bit better. Alright. Are we going Dunkin' after this? He's laughing at me. Are we? Jesse, I gotta talk him into going junking. He's been the one wanting to go junking actually lately, and it's pretty awesome. Cause now I just don't even say anything, and he's like, you know, I was thinking maybe we can go junking. I'm loving this. I got him hooked. It's definitely an addiction. All right, so those look pretty cute on that side. And I got more finds I got to share with you guys here soon, too. I found a whole bunch more stuff that I got to go live with, so I might do that later today. So exciting. All right. Looks good. Move this one over a little bit. It looks so pretty. I love the red and white together. I'm liking this. I'm loving it. I must have been like thinking red today because I have red on my headband. I got all black on. I don't know. It's my style today, apparently. Oops. All right. Put this back on there somewhere. This little flower popped off. I don't know where it popped off on one of these things. Yeah, it looks good right there. We'll stick it there. Oops, backwards. Okay, there we go. All right. That looks good. Perfect. All right. So I'm going to let that dry a little bit more, but look how stinking cute that looks. Isn't it adorable? And you can add other things too if you want to, or adjust these a little bit more. I just love it. I think they look so cute. I might move these over a tiny bit more. And you can now make it fuller, you can make it less full, you can put one big flower on there. I just love it. This one here would look really cute, which now I'm looking at it. I would love to put like little garden tools on this one somehow. I think it would look absolutely gorgeous. And put maybe like welcome to the garden or something like that. I think it would look really cute. This would be really cute on like a garden shed door. Oh, loving it. I need a garden shed now. I mean, come on, right? I have the wreath for it. I need the garden shed. Trying to talk my husband into that one today. All right, let me bring you guys a little bit closer here. So I'm going to just show you guys how I normally would hang this here. I just got a piece of farmer's twine. All right. And I just cut this. And like I said, you don't even need to use the farmer's twine. If you have a door hanger, you can just use it like that. But I just put the twine on it because I think it, there's like twine on everything I do. So, you know, I just did that. Plus, it came with like a perfect hole. So like, why not use it, right? I mean, I don't know. I'm crazy. Okay, so I'm just going to use that. I'm going to put a knot there. Okay, so I'm just tying the loop. All right, just a simple loop. I'm going to knot it twice. All right. Awesome. Okay. So there we go. Making sure it's pretty tight on there. Looks good. And then all I'm going to do is run it up straight, the loop part, straight up through that hole. And there you go. And then I'm going to cut this here, just like that. Okay. So now you can hang it. That way you can even hang it on your wall. You don't even necessarily have to hang it on the door. You can put a nail on your wall or a command strip, and it's pretty heavy. The tires are pretty heavy. So make sure, you know, if you're going to do that, you're going to put something in there that will hold it pretty well. Okay. But that is it. And then you can write whatever you want on the chalkboard. I'm going to actually print stuff out on my Cricut and then just put it on here. So completely up to you guys. You guys can just get a chalk pen or chalk, or even, you know, if you have really good handwriting. I do not. I'm not even going to attempt that on a video because my handwriting is horrible. So I'd rather print it out on the Cricut. So that's what I'm going to do. This is my one from today, and I am going to be making a lot of these. Absolutely. I just got done folding like 10 books. So I would have them so I can, you know, sell them hopefully. So that I just got done with, and I am almost done with all of my doily screens. So I made a whole bunch of those. I'll have to show you guys here at the end of this video, but I've been like working like crazy on duplicate stuff. So this will be a good thing to pull my attention away from everything else that I've been working on. So like I said, one from today, it looks so cute. And then my one from yesterday that I made. So I did flowers just on one side of that one. But I love these. It is so simple, easy, 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 easy. So if you're driving to work and you see a bike rim on the side of the road, do not let it go. Like, look at this. Like, you can make this from it. Who would have thought? Something that somebody is pitching, and this is what you can make from it. I mean, come on. You can even do a double one. Like, I will never pass these up again. I will fight somebody for these. So if you're in the Johnstown area and you see bike rims, I'm coming for you. So put up a fight. but I'm so excited. These are an awesome project today. Let's see here. Let's see. I got some comments. I'm going to reply here. Do, 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 do. Yes, Kathy. Thank you for asking. Lainey is feeling better. She has been 100% now for the last 2 days. She was scaring me there for a little bit because she was kind of showing signs of what she had before. She was throwing up a little bit, so I was a little nervous. But yeah, she's been really good. Thank you so much for asking. Thank you for all the prayers and everything, you guys, because she is feeling great. Thank goodness. Let's see. Chunking. Oh, really, Tammy? That's awesome. Yeah, he never really told me that. I didn't realize he did that. Let's see here. Let's see. Do, 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 do. Repeating. I was repeating? I'm sorry, Becky. I didn't know I was repeating anything. Let's see. Love it, Christine. Awesome. Yes, he was being nice. Let's see. Oh, he says he can't bring me a garden shed. Oh, come on, babe. Let's see. She shed. Yes, Helen. Yes, absolutely. Tammy, real cute. Love you too, Mom. Uh-huh. I hear you, babe. All right. So that's pretty much what today's project was. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know you guys were kind of excited about the bike rims, and so was I. So I will take you over here. I'll just show you my books and stuff that I've been working on. Why not, right? Okay. Sorry. Don't mind my... It's a mess over here because I've been like... crazy craft woman. Okay, so I'm gonna flip you around here. So these are the books I've been working on. This is what I've been doing at night, just sitting here folding books. And that one's not finished yet, but I've been sitting here just folding all of these, and then I have been also working on my screens as well. So it's been crazy here, crazy. But hopefully, and then of course some of my finds that I have just stacking up over here. I'm looking like a hoarder, but you know. So yeah, guys, that was it. I hope you enjoyed it. Tomorrow I am making, at 10:30 a.m. again, I am making the coasters, all right? And these are the pellet knife coasters. If you don't know what pellet knives are, they do have them at the dollar store. I just have the cheap ones because I just started with the pellet knives. They, let me see. That one's messy. So they're just the plastic knives, okay? And they're used for painting. Let me see here. I'll show you these two. These two are a little bit better of an example. So they just come in a pack. I think I got these at Michael's. And there's different ways that you can paint with them. So tomorrow we are doing the coasters. I'm using acrylic paints with the palette knives, all right? And you'll need pretty much paint for doing this because you don't just use a little bit, you use a lot. All right, so if you want to join me tomorrow, learn how to do that. You could probably even use like a plastic butter knife if you want to be creative. So, all right, guys. Well, thank you so much for viewing. Share and like. That's all I ask from you guys. You know, if you are watching, just support and share. So, all right, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you tomorrow, 10:30. Bye.